show parties everywhere a buzz for the fact that next week Luger and Hogan will vie for the world title live here on Nitro.
What tremendous news, Shivani, and I can't wait.
But thanks.
Lex Luger's probably the only man in pro wrestling history that has ever had Hogan up in that rack twice. And he can do it the third time. He's been WCW heavyweight champion before. And with millions and millions of people all over the world watching, I wouldn't doubt that he can't do it again.
And we know how important home field, home court advantage is in pro sports. Hogan was thinking that he would defend the title in Sturgis in front of these people, as he calls them. Not going to happen. Palace of Auburn Hills in Detroit on Luger's home turf with his hometown crowd behind him. And the WCW fans have an opportunity to cheer Luger on and bring that title belt back home.
You know, Mike, today he has no home court advantage.
Well, let's not forget, though, the match is still Stein for Road Wild, but it could be Lex Luger going to Sturgis as the world champ, and it'll be the first return match against Hollywood Hogan. That, of course, will pan out over the next couple of weeks. Syxx has made his way to the ring, and Kimberly will lead in DDP, Diamond Dallas Page.
Master of the Diamond Cutter.
You can put that Diamond Cutter up there with the torture rack.
Figure four.
The figure four leg lock.
Sleeper.
The sleeper hold.
Pile driver.
Yes, sir. The Diamond Cutter.
And all those holds you're talking about, Shivani, you've got to get a man in pretty good shape to take him out. With the Diamond Cutter, you can do it just about anyway.
As a matter of fact, last week it happened to Kurt Hennig. Hennig was in the ring going one-on-one against Mr. Wall Street. And then out of the stands comes Diamond Dallas Page. And after he won the match, Hennig was going to put him maybe into a bulldog or a DDT, and showing you the Diamond Cutter can come from anywhere out of the potential suplex. There it was! The Diamond Cutter, Kurt Hennig has felt the Diamond Cutter, and now DDP and Hennig coming up at Road Wild, Mike, today, one-on-one.
Well, if you listen to our TBS program on Saturday night, Kurt Hennig claimed that DDP hit him from behind. We just saw it on the video. He had the fisherman suplex applied. He blocked it and nailed him with the Diamond Cutter.
And you know, DDP in the ring right now has got his hands on one of the members of the NWO. We all know what he's done to Savage. Watch, he's been playing mind games, and I think he's the only man here at WCW that really knows how to get to the NWO.
This is a good opportunity for Diamond Dallas Page. We received a phone call from the Outsiders, Paul and Nash, the other two members of the Wolfpack, so they are not here in Charleston, West Virginia. So for this man, Syxx, he must go alone without his other two cronies with him, so to speak. Look at this, seeking refuge in the corner, and Page will chase him in the corner now. You know, momentum is such a big part of our sport, guys. Diamond Dallas, you can see it in his face, the momentum he has in matches.
And the hatred he has.
That's right. Pick up, look at this.
Oh!
Page with a great backbreaker on Syxx.
See, he always does something out of the unexpected. You figured it was just going to be a slam to the mat, but no, he interjected a backbreaker in there.
Looked like the pump handle into the slam. You're right. Instead, in midair, he changed it and caught him with a backbreaker.
And he wouldn't have done that 6 months to a year ago. But now, this man, DDP, is an established star here at WCW.
Trying maybe a BO out of the ropes that time. Blocked by DDP and a swinging neckbreaker. And Page calling out to the standing room only crowd at the Civic Center Coliseum. And there's an atomic drop. And a back elbow, and Syxx goes to the floor. Well, you can just feel the excitement here in the air. Everywhere we go on Nitro, and how is it going to be next week when we are live with Hogan and Luger for the world title? Right now, though, Syxx rebounding with a move of his own, and as he approaches Page, he's got his man down in the ring. Into the rib cage with repeated kicks and a back kick that time from Syxx. Syxx and the Nature Boy Ric Flair. Another mega event that has been signed for Road Wild. And here comes one of his patented moves here.
Catch him with the Bronco ride, he calls it, in the corner. You know, almost as amazing as DDP's in-ring success has been the way that the WCW fans have adopted him as a fan favorite. We heard the crowd just chanting DDP, trying to get him fired up.
I'll tell you, if Syxx wants to hop on a mechanical bull, he picked the wrong one, because DDP is alive and well, and he's standing right now.
And the reason the fans have adopted him, Mike, today is very obvious. In the never-ending fight, seemingly against the NWO, Page has been in the front line each and every time, carrying the banner of WCW. And now he's going to go for the diamond cutter. We've got Vincent in the ring. And the Buzz Killer is trying to put it on, trying to put his move on. DDP!
God, you're right, he's got him.
Incredible, another variation of that diamond cutter. Blocked it out of the butt. Kurt Hennig
is out here. Oh, and he hit him in the back of the head.
He's got something. What did he hit him
something
with?
Something in his hand.
Something in his hand or wrapped around his hand.
Something big.
And he rolls Syxx over on DDP. One, two, three.
Both men are unconscious. I guess Kurt Hennig must consider that payback from last week.
I think that it's pretty obvious that Kurt Hennig is not a horseman. He caused the NWO to win.
He might be.
He might be. It looks like he is a member of the NWO. And it was moments ago we were saying he was a member of the Horsemen. But he caused a member of the NWO to win. Mike, the clue here is he not only hit DDP, but he rolled the man on top of him.
Well, the only thing I can say, he still claims he's a free agent. It's obvious to me that he's looking for the biggest money offer available.
No doubt about it. Here you see DDP with that diamond cutter on Syxx. He knows he's got him. He doesn't see.
But
right hitting behind him. Blast him right in the back of the head.
Oh, boy.
And he went out like a light. Look what Kurt Hennig has on his hand there. See?
He has something on his hand, you're right.
And then he rolls Syxx on top. Gets out of there real, real quick. Referee has only one thing to do, and that's count to three. Your winner, Syxx of the NWO.
Is Hennig Horseman, is the NWO, or does he hate DDP just that much?
Yes.
Fans, will be back live on Nitro. Stay with us.
Probably all three. Who knows?